A typical high tunnel is big enough to walk in. That's why they call them high tunnels and not low tunnels. They are covered with something that lets sunlight in, and they're typically used to grow crops.
It's a greenhouse structure that's not heated actively. It's passive heating through solar radiation.
A typical structure would, like the one you see behind me, have bows spaced anywhere from 4 to 6 feet apart and then be covered with film plastic material that lets the sunlight in.
The difference between a high tunnel and a greenhouse is simply the heating, or the lack thereof. In a true greenhouse, you have active heating, whether it be a fuel source like propane or wood.
Typically used to extend the growing season in the spring or the fall and into the winter, so you can get a little longer cropping season.
We decided to put high tunnels on our farm to provide extra income, to diversify our income, and to help keep our son at home on the farm.
Then there are all various types of sizes. They can be different lengths. They can be made out of different materials, and then they can have different ventilation systems. It's in the end walls. You can have some have vents in the roof, so there are different venting mechanisms.
So my thought is that the crop has to be able to pay its rent. It's going to be living within a square foot, give or take a few square feet, and if it's not giving you the output that you need to maintain the operation of that facility, then it's a problem. So it's bell peppers, tomatoes, herbs, lettuce, edible flowers.
High tunnel, we've only grown tomatoes, and we've experimented growing cucumbers and hanging baskets to utilize the total square footage of the high tunnel.
People who've had success seemingly with strawberries and with raspberries, some of the brambles, they seem to be having success. In terms of cool season crops, people are growing things like spinach, lettuce, kale, some of the root crops.
Some of the advantages for high tunnels, again, it comes back to a market window. It allows you to plant maybe even up to a month or 2 months earlier than you normally would be able to plant in the field. Again, if you plant a month or 2 months earlier than you normally would in the field, that means you have tomatoes ready or crops ready, available before anybody else would when they're growing in the field, so prices generally will be high.
Less disease pressure with a high tunnel, more controlled environment. You extend your growing season by 3 to 6 weeks on either end.
Some people would prefer to spread their work out through the year more and not have to work so much.
Changes would, in my mind, are probably more have to do with lack of experience and understanding of how what the environment is like in those structures. You have to have a good understanding of what the climate's like, how you're going to manage those crops. Generally speaking, if you're growing tomatoes and bell peppers and cucumbers, if you want to try to maximize the space, meaning the whole volume of the structure, in my opinion, growing trellising vegetable crops is something of interest, but there's a lot of labor. There's even more labor than associated with high tunnels with some crops than there is even in the field setting.
I farmed all my life, garden, custom baled hay, and we thought when we got into the produce it would be just like farming or gardening, but it's a lot more in depth.
The disadvantages are that managing the environment is important, and it can take time, and it can be a daily necessity. So when it gets hot, the temperature inside the tunnel can increase very quickly to beyond what the plants will tolerate. Growing in the soil, you don't necessarily have the opportunity to rotate that soil to different crops as much as you might like for disease prevention, because oftentimes people will want to put the same high value crop in the tunnel because that's the thing they can make money on.
If I were to start over again, I would do more pre-planning on the layout where each high tunnel would sit. I would explore my markets better.
Fruit and Vegetable Connection website, under the section called Season Extension, we have some links to resources. There's a series of videos that was done in 2010 by the Great Lakes Vegetable Working Group.
But what I would recommend is seeking out information from a land grant institute, from a state, if you can't find it locally, but from a state that is similar to the conditions which you as the grower will be working.
Purdue has offers programs from time to time, you know, in the future, so you can keep your eye out for those.
We might be driving down the road, see a high tunnel operation or a greenhouse operation, produce operation. We stop and ask questions. 95% of people are more than happy to offer you information.
Advisor once told me that there's no money in growing vegetables, there's only money in selling vegetables. So unless you have a market already established or some sort of idea of where you want to take your product, I think you need to slow down a bit and focus on that first. And once the market's been developed, or you've at least identified a viable market, then you can start moving forward with the additional processes.